Sam from Sweetcorn Man back with another video. The Sweetcorn History segment in this video will be on the Mexican-American War. The presidential election of 1844 lasted from November 1st, 1844 to December 4th, 1844. There were 275 members of the Electoral College and 138 electoral votes were needed to win. For the Whig Party, President John Tyler of Virginia was expelled from the Whig Party, and as such, the Whigs needed a new candidate. Party leader and former U.S. Senator Henry Clay of Kentucky was the sole candidate for the Whig nomination for the presidency. The candidates for vice president were former governor of Massachusetts John Davis, former U.S. Representative Millard Fillmore of New York, former U.S. Representative John Sargent of Pennsylvania, and former mayor of Newark, New Jersey, Theodore Frelinghuysen. The Whig National Convention took place on May 1, 1844 in Baltimore, Maryland. Henry Clay was unanimously nominated, winning all 275 delegates. The first vote for Clay's running mate was deadlocked, with no candidate winning a majority of the votes. Frelinghuysen won 101 delegates, Davis won 83 delegates, Fillmore won 53 delegates, and Sargent won 38 delegates. As such, a second vote was held. The results were 116 votes for Frelinghuysen, 75 votes for Davis, 51 votes for Fillmore, and 33 votes for Sargent. Once again, no candidate won a majority of votes. A third vote was held, with the results being 154 votes for Frelinghuysen, 79 votes for Davis, 40 votes for Fillmore, and 0 votes for Sargent. Two delegates declined to vote. As such, the Whig ticket was Henry Clay for president and Theodore Frelinghuysen for vice president. For the Democrats, the Democratic candidates for president were Secretary of State John Calhoun of South Carolina, U.S. Senator James Buchanan of Pennsylvania, U.S. Senator Levi Woodbury of New Hampshire, U.S. Naval Captain Charles Stewart of Pennsylvania, former President Martin Van Buren of New York, former Vice President Richard Johnson of Kentucky, and former U.S. Ambassador to France Louis Cass of Michigan. Van Buren was the early frontrunner, but the problem with his candidacy was that he was opposed to the annexation of the Republic of Texas, which was not only popular in the Democratic Party, but throughout the United States as well. Nevertheless, Van Buren entered the Democratic National Convention with the highest amount of support. The Democratic National Convention was held from May 27, 1844 to May 29, 1844 in Baltimore, Maryland. When the delegates voted, the results were 1 vote for Stewart, 2 votes for Woodbury, 4 votes for Buchanan, 6 votes for Calhoun, 24 votes for Johnson, 83 votes for Cass, and 146 votes for Van Buren. As such, Van Buren won the most votes, but failed to win a 2/3 majority of the delegates, which was required by the convention. A second vote was held, with Van Buren winning the most votes again, but no candidate reaching a majority. By the 9th ballot, no candidate had won a 2/3 majority. One delegate named George Bancroft suggested former governor of Tennessee James Polk for the Democratic nomination. Former governor of Massachusetts Marcus Morton was also put forward. The results for the 9th ballot were 0 votes for Johnson, Buchanan, Woodbury, and Stewart, 1 vote for Morton, 2 votes for Van Buren and Calhoun, 29 votes for Cass, and 231 votes for Polk. Therefore, Polk was nominated by the Democratic Party. The candidates for the vice presidential nomination were U.S. Senator Silas Wright of New York, U.S. Senator John Fairfield of Maine, former U.S. Minister to Russia George Mifflin Dallas of Pennsylvania, former Governor of New York William Marcy. Woodbury, Johnson, Stewart, and Cass were also considered. Wright was unanimously nominated on the first ballot, but he declined. No candidate was able to reach a majority of delegates on the second ballot. Finally, a winner came forward with the third ballot. The results were 0 votes for Wright, Cass, Johnson, and Marcy, 6 votes for Woodbury, 30 votes for Fairfield, and 219 votes for Dallas. Therefore, the Democratic ticket was James Polk for president and George Mifflin Dallas for vice president. Former Kentucky State Representative James Burney, who moved to Michigan, once again emerged as the Liberty Party nominee for president. This time, former U.S. Senator Thomas Morris of Ohio was the party's vice presidential nominee. Mayor of Nauvoo, Illinois, Joseph Smith ran an independent campaign, having Mormon leader Sidney Rigdon of Illinois as his running mate. President John Tyler of Virginia also chose to run for a presidential term in his own right. He created a political party called the New Democratic Republican Party, named after Thomas Jefferson's political party, which had split 16 years earlier. Tyler was nominated on May 30th, 1844. The party did not name a running mate. Unlike the 1840 campaigns, which were mostly focused on personal attacks, the 1844 campaign was issue-centered. The biggest issue of the election was the annexation of the Republic of Texas. Polk, Tyler, and Smith all supported the annexation of Texas, with Polk and Tyler being the most vocal about it. The Democratic Party platform advocated the annexation of Texas, the annexation of the Oregon Territory, negotiating a border dispute with Great Britain, lower tariffs, and support for immigration. The Democrats attacked the Whigs as anti-immigration bigots and claimed that Theodore Frelinghuysen was an anti-Catholic. The Democratic campaign slogan was 54-40 or fight, referencing Polk's position on the Oregon Territory border dispute. The Whigs advocated opposition to the annexation of Texas, high tariffs, and support for internal improvements. The Whigs' slogan was, "Hurrah, hurrah, the country's rising for Henry Clay and Frelinghuysen." Clay had gotten himself into a dilemma, however. His opposition to the annexation of Texas cost him the support of Southerners, who thought he was trying to end the spread of slavery. However, Clay himself was a slaveholder, leading to Northern abolitionists supporting James Birney. The Liberty Party ran as a single-issue party advocating for the abolition of slavery. Joseph Smith advocated both the abolition of slavery as well as the annexation of Texas and Oregon. Smith also supported abolishing prisons, free trade, and bringing back the National Bank. However, Smith was shot to death by a mob on June 27, 1844, in Carthage, Illinois, ending his campaign. The New Democratic Republicans ran as a single-issue party supporting the annexation of Texas. Democrats, however, worried that President Tyler and the New Democratic Republicans could gain votes from otherwise Democratic voters. Former Governor Polk and former President Andrew Jackson had former President Andrew Jackson convince Tyler that a Polk administration would annex Texas. As a result, Tyler withdrew from the election on August 20th, 1844. The results. Democrat James Polk won the election, winning 170 electoral votes from New York, Pennsylvania, Virginia, Indiana, Georgia, Alabama, Illinois, Maine, South Carolina, Missouri, Louisiana, Mississippi, New Hampshire, Michigan, and Arkansas. Polk also won 1,338,464 popular votes. This was the first time a Democrat won Georgia since 1832. Whig Henry Clay won 105 electoral votes from Ohio, Tennessee, Kentucky, Massachusetts, North Carolina, Maryland, New Jersey, Connecticut, Vermont, Rhode Island, and Delaware. Clay's victory in both Tennessee and North Carolina made James Polk the first winning presidential candidate to lose both his birth and home states. Clay won 1,300,097 popular votes. James Birney won no electoral votes. However, his support among abolitionists in New York cost Clay the election. Had every vote Birney received in New York gone to Clay, Clay would have won the state and in turn the election. Birney won 62,300 popular votes. James Polk and George Dallas were inaugurated on March 4, 1845. At age 49, Polk became the youngest president at his inauguration for the time. All right, time for Sequent History. James Polk was able to annex the Republic of Texas on December 29, 1845. However, there was a dispute over where the southern border of Texas was. Polk sent U.S. Representative John Slidell of Louisiana to negotiate with Mexico, hoping to not only settle the border dispute, but to acquire the Mexican provinces of Santa Fe de Nuevo México and Alta California. Mexico denied Slidell's offers, and tensions between the United States and Mexico increased. Polk sent 3,000 troops under the command of Major General Zachary Taylor of Kentucky to the disputed Rio Grande. On April 25th, 1846, Mexican troops crossed the Rio Grande and broke out into a skirmish where 11 Americans were killed. Therefore, President Polk asked Congress for a declaration of war, stating that the Mexican soldiers had shed American blood upon American soil. Many Whigs were critical of Polk's declaration, believing that the territories Polk wanted to gain would be used to expand slavery. On May 12, 1846, Congress voted on the war. The results: 40-2 in the Senate and 174-14 in the House of Representatives. One of the representatives who voted against the war was the former president and U.S. Representative John Quincy Adams of Massachusetts. The next day, war would be officially declared. U.S. Representative David Wilmot of Pennsylvania would introduce his proviso to ban slavery in all territories acquired during the war. However, President Polk opposed the Wilmot proviso. The war was controversial, with even some soldiers who fought in the war opposing it. For example, Lieutenant Ulysses Grant of Louisiana would later call it one of the most unjust ever waged by a stronger against a weaker nation, by a stronger nation against a weaker nation. Lieutenant Colonel Stephen W. Kearney of Missouri captured Santa Fe, the capital of Nuevo Mexico. Meanwhile, Brevet Captain John C. Fremont of the Oregon Territory captured Alta California and established the Bear Flag Republic. The Americans were outnumbered but were skillful and had superior technology, leading to numerous victories during late 1846 and 1847. In February 1847, the Americans won the Battle of Buena Vista, one of the biggest battles of the war. American forces under Zachary Taylor as well as John Wool had high morale during the battle due to it occurring on the 115th birthday of George Washington. This increased patriotism among the soldiers. By the end of the battle, the Mexicans were exhausted and starving. Therefore, Mexican commander Antonio Lopez de Santa Anna surrendered and withdrew his troops. The casualties in the battle were 267 Americans killed compared to 591 Mexicans, 387 Americans wounded compared to 1,048 Mexicans, and 6 Americans missing compared to 1,894 Mexicans. Later in 1847, U.S. Representative Abraham Lincoln of Illinois would write the spot resolutions where he asked President Polk to point to the spot where American blood was shed, saying that the territory was disputed and therefore not good justification for the war. The war finally ended on February 3, 1848, with the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo, which granted the United States the Mexican Cession, or Alta California and Santa Fe de Nuevo Mexico, to the United States, as well as settling the border dispute, with the border being at the Rio Grande. The Wilmot Proviso was rejected, and as such, slavery was allowed to spread to the unorganized territory. Alright, that's it for today, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this entertaining and informative. Check out the Discord server if you haven't. The link is in the description. And yeah, that's it for today. Or maybe I'll release something today, later today, but I don't know. See ya.